Father himself. He said, take crucified.
Yeah.
When Jesus stood before the people, because see, Herod was already looking to kill him when he was a baby. Yeah. Now Herod said, oh, now this is the Jesus that you talk about. He said, this is a, he said, I want to see him do signs, miracles, and wonders.
Oh, yes.
But see, these are the same folks that talk to you behind your back and say, oh, since you're so highly anointed, let me see you prophesy. Oh.
The backstabber.
How in the world? You got some people that says, oh, you so highly anointed. Let me see you do some signs, miracles, and wonders if you say you got the Holy Ghost.
Come on.
But once I don't have to prove nothing to you because I've already been justified. I've already been proven. I don't have to write you a handwritten resume of who I am in the body of Christ. I don't understand why we chastise and crucify one another when we so-called supposed to be pushing one another in the body of Christ. But we are saying Hosanna in each other's face and go right behind each other's back and say crucify.
Come on. Come on, Apostle.
So he's preparing us for the battle. He said, take no thought, take nothing with you. He said, this is why I'm sending you out by twos. He said, it's time to prepare our mind. It's a spiritual warfare going on in our mind as if we don't understand what Jesus is saying in this hour. Some of us need to go back, hallelujah, and read the lifestyle of Jesus because we just don't get it, Apostle.
Oh, my God.
We don't get all of the chastisement, the spitting on. And you never saw Jesus say, oh, I give up. Every time a little wind blow, he never said, I give up, because he knew his assignment.
That's it.
If you don't know your assignment in this hour and this season, it's imprevalent that you seek the Holy Ghost and get in position. And once you are in position, soldier, stay in line. Don't get out of your position when he has already prepared that position for you.
I receive that. I ain't getting out of line.
So if we're getting out of line in the body of Christ, that's letting Yahweh know that I don't want that position. I wasn't built for this, but guess what my back says? I'm built for this. So therefore, I'm not going to give up my position in the body of Christ. I'm built for the position that he put me in. So what if you overlook me? Guess what? As long as that I am pleasing to God, it doesn't matter if you believe even the words that are coming out of my mouth on tonight, because my life has already been established.
Come on.
By the Holy Ghost. My name is already written in the Lamb's book of life. And I tell you, not a soul that's walking this earth can remove my name out of the Lamb's book of life.
Alright.
So if we just remain in position, hallelujah, just like a soldier is on the front line, he can't get out of his position. Because if he moves out of position, it will cause the whole back line, hallelujah, to come under attack of the enemy.
Come on here.
You got to know your role. You got to know your assignment. Yeah. But let me go back to Luke 23.
Come on here.
I said, Father, why did they not just let him go if Pilate said he didn't find no audit?
Come on, Apostle.
The governor.
Because he was listening to all the other naysayers. Uh-oh. So in the body of Christ, why are you listening to the naysayers and causing you to get out of position? Why are you listening to those that didn't even give you the assignment in the beginning?
Come on, speak now.
In the first place.
So I don't understand the people in the body of Christ when even your best friend, when the Father said, I need you to disconnect so I can do more in you. But yet you still stick around to them same old stale folk. I know I'm going to get in trouble, but I'm going to obey the Holy Ghost. When he told you once before, over and over, see, God said, I'm not going to keep repeating myself. This is why the spiritual warfare has intensified in your life, because you are, for one, out of order. For two, you don't lost your identity because you have listened to other people put you in a position that you don't even own.
Oh my God.
So if we continue, hallelujah, to be before the Father.
Yeah.
And stop listening to Herod, because you got some Herods in your life. They will say, I need to see what you all about. You don't owe Herod no explanation. If the Father tell you to pack up and go to Missouri tonight, I bet you expediently to pack up and go to Missouri. You don't owe nobody, no man, no explanation. If the Father tell you, and I mean you and you alone, to pack up and move, he didn't say take your whole family.
Come on.
That's the main reason why he's pulling you away from family.
Woo!
Because they are stumbling blocks. They are your Herods. They are your Herods that's holding you up.
Come on.
You better preach.
They're holding you up in this hour. So Jesus said, he didn't say a word while he was standing up there on the crucified. He had his mouth closed. So what that told me is, he said, oh, none of y'all know explanation. I'm here on an assignment. This assignment must be complete and I cannot forfeit it. Satan tried to come and cause him to forfeit. Peter even walked with him and tried to cause him to forfeit. Come on here. So you even got those that so-called supposed to be your brethren and sister in Christ that walk with you in your assignment that will try to cause you to get out of alignment because they want to steal your spot anyway.
That's it.
They want to steal your spot anyway. They don't feel like, oh, Father, you put me in the wrong position. Why am I on the back? Why am I in the back of the line? I'm supposed to be on the front. See, too many of us want to be on the front line. But soon as the arrows and the dots come, you want to duck and hide, want to run in the back. It ain't time for y'all to duck and hide. It's time for you to stand still like a soldier.
That's right.
And take those battle wounds, hallelujah, like a good soldier, because I guarantee the one that's standing behind you going to catch you if you fall.
Oh, my God.
The one that's standing behind you, and I'm talking about some real true soldiers in the body of Christ, going to pick you up in the spirit just like Apostle Therial picked me up. In the spirit and said, no, you gotta push through this. You gotta push through this. Even though the warfare has been intense. The warfare has been intense. We give the enemy too much credit in the battle. We give him too much power. Oh, the devil doing this. And the devil doing that. The devil said, they laughing. Because the devil said, I ain't even doing nothing. But you family is psychological warfare. You have caused your own self to get in the way of what God is trying to do in your life. If you would just go sit your hind paws down and wait on God to bring you forth, he said, I will exalt you. I will bring your name before great kings and queens. I will put you at the table that I want you to be at. Hallelujah.
You better preach.
He said, I'm going to prepare the table for you.
Yes, Lord.
But it's too many of us out here preparing our own table. Did you see in Luke 23 that Jesus prepared his own table?
No,
he was sent because the Father told him, this is what you're going to have to do in order to save my people. So even though the fire has been intensified in your life, hallelujah, we just got to continue to press. Press in. Keep praying. Keep reading your word. Because we're going to need the word. Because we are in our end times. If you have not been seeing the times and the seasons. Many of us are not watching the times and the seasons. We always want to watch our big name prophet preach to me. Prophesy to me. Let me tell you one thing about Satan. You don't care nothing about your house, cars, and clothes.
None of that.
Oh, he attacking my finances. No, you're just not a good steward.
That's it.
Oh, he attacking my children. No, because you haven't done away. You haven't broken the bloodline over your children. This is why your children is going through, because the bloodline has not been broken. See, I talked to Apostle Deidre today. She said, listen, my people perish for lack of knowledge. And when I thought about it, and the Holy Ghost gave me a different revelation, when I thought about it, I said, you know what, God? I said, many people don't want the knowledge.
They don't want it.
They just want amen. You want a quick fix. Right. Enough to get them to the next step. They don't want what God has for eternity. They want something temporary.
Woo!
defense, and guess what? Now he's coming for his blood that he required.
You better preach.
Because see, the blood of Jesus.
You better preach. The blood.
All he wants is your mind and your heart to be purified. All he wants is you. But see, Satan, he wants your soul.
That's what he wants.
He wants your soul. Y'all stay with me. I know she just all over. Let me tell y'all something.
No, you're not. You're
right in the vein. I'm going to obey the Holy Ghost on tonight. Because many of y'all right now on social media are suffering at the hands of the enemy.
Tell it. They suffering.
Because they want to run after they are apostles and prophets that have big names and big platforms. And like our daughter said, they don't want the glory. They glory chase us. They don't want the real glory. They glory chase us. And once they get what they want to get, they gone.
That's it.
But I'm going to tell you one thing about me and my husband. When you come back, you're going to get deliverance, and I'm going to send you back out the door. Because see, one thing for sure, we're not going to play with nobody's soul, spirit, or anything of that nature. So let me go back to the text.
Obey.
King Herod wanted to see him do signs, miracles, and wonders. Jesus never opened up his mouth. So the people was constantly saying, crucify him. Crucify him. But Jesus never said nothing. He didn't have to explain himself because he was obeying what the Father had already given him the assignment to do. So if we just obey even in the assignments that he has already prepared us for.
God, I thank you.
So none of us have an excuse about, I wasn't prepared for this.
Come on. That's what we said.
I ain't ready yet.
We was already prepared when we was in our mother's womb.
That's right.
You better know it.
It just needed to be pushed and activated. But because you want your big name preacher, hallelujah, to lay hands on you, now you have miscarried in the spirit.
Yes.
See, Jesus was a miscarriage. When the angel of the Lord visited Mary and he gave her that word, she accepted her assignment.
Yes, she did.
And she didn't let nobody put their hands on her. Nobody came and spoke to her wound. What is this foolishness in the body of Christ? We got some spiritual abortionists walking around in the body of Christ. Because they are jealous and envy of you or what you have.
That's what it is.
But you never see Jesus and his disciples do anything.
Never.
You never seen them backbite each other and fight with each other. So now the Father said, I'm getting ready to raise up my real remnant. Y'all out here playing tonight. You the real remnant. But you out here backbiting. You out here talking about your brother and sister. You full of jealousy. You full of envy. It's not of God. I'm coming for you next tonight.
Come on.
Let me tell y'all one thing. This battle and this warfare is real. It's real. And if you ain't prepared when you should have already been in preparation, you're going to get taken out by the hands of the enemy. Because I asked the Father, I said, Lord, what is Satan really after being after our cars, clothes, our possessions in the land? Because you do know Satan owned this land.
Come on.
So therefore, what did Jesus say? He said, I don't want your possessions. The stuff that belongs to this world, Satan owns it.
That's it.
The God of
You hear me?
He's the God of this world. And I said, Father, what is Satan trying to steal? He said, Satan comes to steal your time and your mind. He said, if I can get those two,
you better preach.
I can talk. He said, if I can get those two, I got you. That way he can wipe out your whole generation. Because the Father said, I wanted to do some generation. You got to open up your eyes and see that the hands of the enemy is after our next generation. And we are so blinded by our own self that we don't even understand that the devil is taking out our younger generation.
That's it.
We said we praying for them. We training them up.
That's what we say.
Right. But I'm seeing y'all on social media saying something different. Your children bouncing like Beyonce, dressing like Rihanna. How are you saying you praying for your children? You training them up by the ways of the word of God.
Wow. That's it.
You better preach.
Let me tell y'all something. If we don't get these children in alignment with the Father and the Holy Ghost, I'm telling you our generation will be gone.
Yeah, that's the truth.
Our next generation will be gone. Let me go back to the text.
Glory to God. Oh my God.
See, King Herod, he was a con man.
Yes, yeah.
He was a murderer. He really wanted Jesus to be, he wanted him to be crucified anyway. But because they was listening to the people and not listening to God on what they need to be doing concerning Jesus. But you also got to look at it that it was necessary for him to go through what he went through, because if he didn't go through, we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be here.
Oh my God.
So,
oh my God.
Oh, I'm going to wrap it up, y'all.
Take your time. Do what God say do.
I'm going to say this, and I'm going to hand it over to my husband.
Glory to God.
You better obey.
I'm telling you.
If you have not prepared your mind on today, and you keep allowing the people to push you into an assignment that the Father never called you to be in, you're going to mess up a whole entire generation. We must remain in alignment with the Holy Ghost. It's a crucial hour that we in. If you're saying you love God and you love his people, I'm so compassionate about the people.
Oh my God.
But I'm not seeing the demonstration of unity in the body of Christ.
That's right.
That's what we ain't having.
I'm not seeing
unity
in the body of Christ.
For real.
I'm seeing too many people throwing people under the bus. I'm seeing too many people calling other people witches when they ain't. Warlocks when they ain't. You're listening to the wrong people. You're leaving from your wrong covers and following other covers.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The devil right there.
Then you ask. Then you're working for Satan as an agent.
Yes.
Now you're gonna switch roles. How you gonna go from I love the Lord to you gonna switch roles?
Oh my God.
Help us, apostle.
I just don't understand that.
Oh my God.
I don't understand it. We said we love Christ like we said we did. We love the people.
My God.
Me and my husband's job in this hour is to push the people to their purpose and their destination. It's not. It's never about us.
Never.
It's never about us.
Never.
And see, this is what I tell the people. Me and my husband don't have to give you no resume. The Holy Ghost is going to speak for itself.
Don't speak for it.
We don't have to make announcements when we enter a room. Did Jesus ever make an announcement when he entered into a room?
Never.
They had already picked up on his spirit, and they knew who he was.
That's it.
But the denial had to come for elevation.
That's good.
That's good, Apostle.
The denial has to come in order for us to be elevated. The oil has to be pressed down in order for us to move from dimension to dimension in God.
My God.
This walk with Jesus was never meant to be easy. But he said, I'm going to deliver you out of the mold. These are just light afflictions.
Hallelujah.
Many of us wouldn't be able to take the beatings like Jesus did. Many of us would never, hallelujah, would be able to take the beheading like some of the apostles that they had to go through. But I tell you on tonight, prepare your mind. For war. This is war. We are in a war. We are in a spiritual war. We have to prepare for the battles.
That's it.
It's too many of us want to run to the front line.
My God.
Where are those that want to take care of the wounded ones?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Where are the ones that want to go back and get the one that fell in the hole? You too busy running after the 99.
My God.
And they don't even need the help of the Holy Ghost.
Jesus!
You better preach, girl.
Come on, apostle.
But I'm going to end it right here.
Jesus.
I give God all the glory, the honor, and the praise, and I give him back his glory. I take no glory from him. But let me ask you this one question.
Come on.
Where would you be in the next 5 to 10 years.
Wow.
If you don't have the Holy Ghost.
My God. My God. Good question.
All right.
Where would you be if you do not have the Holy Ghost? If the Father turns your mind over to a reprobate because you want to keep believing the lies of the people, because you want to keep believing the lies of your favorite apostle, because you want to keep believing lies of your favorite prophet, where would you be? Because we can't do this. We can't walk this walk without God himself, nor the Holy Ghost.
My God.
So I pray what was being said on tonight.
Yes, ma'am.
Open up your eyes and understanding that this, even though this warfare is real,
God, I thank you for it, Lord God.
We just need to continue to obey God in all things.
Yes,
and tune out the naysayers and those that don't even mean a thing to your assignment that you were assigned to.
My God.
God bless everyone on Facebook.
Hallelujah.
I love you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
That was a word right there.
Yeah, well,
we heard a word from my beautiful wife, Apostle. Hallelujah. Nina Ross. Hallelujah. Give us strength right now. Touch her right now. Hallelujah. Give us strength. Pour back into her. Hallelujah. Everything that was lost, we pray, Father. Hallelujah. We come against every backbite spirit, every retaliate spirit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Strengthen her right now. Hallelujah. Satan, you're a liar. The word of God is going forth and will not come back void. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Satan, you're a liar. Hallelujah. She has already shifted. She has already elevated. And we give your name praise on tonight. In Jesus' mighty name.
Yes,
hallelujah, hallelujah. I won't be long myself. Am I shy? Lekandabosha. Zechariah chapter 2. Hallelujah.
You hear me? Take your sword.
Verses. Hallelujah. Zechariah chapter 2. Verses 10 through 13. Hallelujah. Paralleling with what my wife just said. The word of the Lord says, I'm going to say it again, Zechariah chapter 2, verses 10 through 13. Hallelujah, because the devil thought he got the victory.
Yeah.
The devil thought he won. Hallelujah. They thought we was crazy. That we having a warfare revival in a city where Nicole was supposed to tear it down. Hallelujah, but I won't hear, oh my God, I come here to let you all know. The prayers, listen here, because I know y'all watching, I know y'all monitoring. The prayers that y'all prayed and went to the witch. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The prayers that y'all prayed and went to the witch and say, hallelujah, send the call to Jacksonville so we won't go forward with this revival. I come here to let you all know tonight, not just own it. Not just only y'all went to the witch, but because of y'all prayers to the witch. We shifted. We elevated. Hallelujah. We give God's name the praise. Hallelujah. I won't be long. I won't be long. Hallelujah. Zechariah chapter 2, verses 10 through 13. Hallelujah. Verse 10 says, sing and rejoice, O daughter of Zion. For lo, I come and I will dwell in the midst of thee, says the Lord. Y'all better hear this prophetic word on today. Hallelujah. Verse 11 says, and many nations shall be joined to the Lord, and in that day,
come on now,
and shall be my people. And I will dwell in the midst of thee. Hallelujah. And thou shalt know that the Lord of hosts has sent me unto thee. Verse 12, and the Lord says, inherit Judah his portion in the Holy Land, and shall choose Jerusalem again. And verse 13 says, be silent, O all flesh, before the Lord, for he is raised up out of his holy habitation. Let me tell you all something. When the Lord is in the midst,
my God,
when he's dwelling on the inside of you, I don't care how many witches come against you. I don't care how many warlocks come against you. You got to understand that when they went to the witch, when they went to the warlock and said we were losing our mind for having this revival, they didn't understand, Apostle John, that the Lord was in the midst. Hallelujah. The
you got a reason.
They just didn't go against us. They went against the Lord. Y'all better hear this word. But because of our obedience, because of our faith, the Father shifted us. And the Father elevated us. From the word of the Lord. And it's back there, John 7:38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. We just didn't come to a revival, but we came together because there was a river flowing in our belly. Hallelujah. I want y'all to understand, if there's a river flowing in your belly, it's not just flowing just to be flowing, but it's an indication that the Lord is in the midst of you. Y'all got to understand, in this hour and in this season, whatever the Lord has purpose, whatever the Lord has purpose, and if we don't walk out in obedience, we're going to be some serious trouble. I come here to let you all know, and the woman of God always said, he's preparing the table. The table is not just for you. The table is for your enemies. Because the Holy Ghost said, in this season, I'm going to allow your enemies to serve you. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. He said, I'm going to allow your enemies to serve you. And it's been purposed by God in this hour. Oh my God. To serve you. So don't be surprised when the Father sends your enemies your way.
Come on.
Why our enemies must really know not just only who we are, but who our Father is. Because they're going to have a testimony, Apostle. I know that the Lord has been with you. I know that the Lord is in the midst of you. Hallelujah. That's why we didn't throw in the towel. That's why the warfare came. That's why the enemy been attacking every last one of us. Because the Father has purposed this day before the foundations of the world. Hallelujah. Y'all better hear me real good. He purposed this day. He purposed it. He purposed the warfare to be intensified. He purposed it. Because there's going to be glory after this. There's going to be glory. So it is a necessity that he be in the midst of us. He said, they're going to know that you are my people.
You my people.
Yes, Lord.
My God.
Lord Jesus.
Come on, preach now.
They're going to know you my people.
My God from Zion.
This is why we ain't got time to go back and forth.
Come on, you better talk, sir.
We ain't got time to go back and forth for y'all. I know y'all, some of y'all watching. I know some of y'all got a word for y'all too. I know some of y'all watching. It is because of y'all prayers to the witches. It's because that's what they've been doing. That's what they've been doing. Hallelujah. That's why we got hit so hard over the so-called Halloween holiday. Hallelujah. Because the Father has purpose. He's purposed this day. He purposed this revival. And God said, if y'all would have just obeyed me, it would have been blood on y'all hands.
Jesus.
God said we would have disobeyed him. Hallelujah. Dr. Jackson, he said, hallelujah, the blood would have been on y'all hands.
That's it.
My God. Jesus, God.
So the ones that got healed and delivered.
Oh, God. It showed us deliverance. It showed us some deliverance.
They would have missed their healing and deliverance.
My God.
And we would have counseled the revival.
My God.
Oh, God.
Help the people, Apostle.
Oh, my God.
Apostle, that's good.
They would have missed it.
They would have missed it.
They would have missed it.
But because of our obedience.
Yes, Lord. Right. Thank you, Lord, for the obedience.
Because of our faithfulness.
God. Yes, God.
God says, God said, because of y'all obedience, in this season, I'm going to show up like you never saw me before. Because y'all didn't allow the cold to stop y'all. Y'all didn't allow the witch to stop y'all. Y'all did not stop, oh my God. Y'all did not allow the warlock to stop y'all.
My God.
So in this season, I'm wrapping it up.
I gotta wrap it up.
In this season, it is a necessity that we allow the people to see not who we are, but who God is.
Come on, my prayer, God,
because God is saying, if we're going to be the remnant, we claim we got all this power and authority. If we say that we got all this power and authority,
all this power.
What many of these folks ain't coming to Christ?
Good question.
Are we acting like donkeys in the body?
That's it.
We acting more like unbelievers than unbelievers in the world.
That's it.
My God.
I praise and I thank God for these three nights.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Because I told the Lord, hallelujah, that this is a necessity. That he called all the prophets, y'all better pay attention, and the apostles to this region.
My God.
Let me tell you something. We are atmospheric shifters.
That's it. We shift.
The rain could not touch us.
We better talk. It could not touch us.
Because once we came into the region, the atmosphere
shifted.
The time that the people was expecting the rain to fall, there was no rain. Check this out. There was a fresh wind.
Oh, my God.
Get ready.
Come on, Pastor John Taylor. Come on, take the platform. We're going to end this one because we are victorious.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. We are winners.
We are
going to win. Come on now. My God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, y'all. Don't stop. We needed that word. That was the word. I'm going to tell you, both of y'all stepped into my sermon today. Y'all really did. Y'all stepped into my sermon. We got to be on God's. We got to be on God's business.
Yes.
We got to take care of what we're supposed to take care of on this healing and deliverance revival.
Tell them how real the revival is.
This is real.
This warfare
is real. I'm going to show you how the devil is trying to stop what has been going on. We had 2 days where we just gave God the praise and God moved in this house. There was healing and deliverance over the last 2 days. But today is the final day.
The final frontier.
And I'm going to tell you how the devil hated how it went on, how good it's been, that he took
my God.
My warfare outfit.
Woo!
The
Didn't everybody look good in their warfare outfits? They all ready to battle. But see, because of one of the leaders,
you better speak.
We're bringing it today. The devil tried to stop him. He took the uniform that he know would defeat him. And he hid. But he didn't know that because of who God is, he can't stop the war. Oh yes, we are victorious. Tonight is the final night. And you know something? We have won the battle. All right?
Yes, Lord.
So with no further ado, first of all, I want to give honor unto God.
Yes, Lord.
For without him, I would not be standing here today.
Yes, Lord.
So I give him all the glory. I give him all the honor. I give him all of me.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord. It's not about me. I'm just what they call a pawn.
I like that.
In this game of chess.
Hey!
That's all. That's all it is. But they don't know that. See, I already have
checkmate.
I already have checkmate. The plan has gone forth.
You better preach, Apostle.
It has already went forth. That's why I have already won the battle.
Hallelujah.
The plan could not be stopped.
That's it.
Woo, Jesus.
No matter how the devil tried. He cannot stop. What God has already planned and proceeded.
Hallelujah.
So with saying that, I want y'all to turn with me to the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 20.
Come on.
And we're going to read verses 1 through 4.
Come on, obey God, tell the nation.
This is about doing and fulfilling the battle.
Come on, Apostle.
Come on. My God.
We know that God is the beginning and the end. He is the creator. He is the starter and the finisher.
Yes, Lord.
So with that alone, we know we can claim the victory.
Hallelujah.
So when y'all get there, y'all say, I'm there, Apostle.
Come on.
Y'all on social media, Facebook, all of that. Y'all go get whatever it is that you read the word of God from, be it iPads, Androids, tablets, whatever it is, the Bible itself.
Yes, Lord.
Because I want you to get this, not because I'm saying it, but it's what thus says the Lord.
Come on.
Amen. Amen. So we're going to Deuteronomy chapter 20, verses 1 through 4. And it reads, it says, when thou goest out to battle against thine enemies, and seest horses, chariots, and people more than thou. Y'all know the devil has an army.
Yes,
he has a lot of them right here on this earth. If you don't believe it, all you got to do is step outside.
Well, there you go. You better speak.
So when you see a people more than thou, be not afraid of them.
I ain't scared.
We ain't scared.
Yeah.
True people of God. We not scared.
Come on,
it says, for the Lord thy God is with thee.
Yes, Lord.
That's why we're not scared.
That's why.
Because we got the baddest person.
You better speak.
That there could ever be on our side.
Yeah.
It says, for the Lord thy God is with thee, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Yes, Lord.
Whether you know it or not, even though we are in North America, we call this USA. This is the now time Egypt.
Woo!
Verse 2 says, and it shall be when you are come nigh unto the battle,
yeah,
that the priest shall approach and speak unto the people,
my God,
and say unto them, hear, O Israel,
my God,
ye approach this day, uh-huh, unto, hallelujah, battle against your enemies.
Yes, Lord.
Let not your heart faint.
Yes, Lord.
Come on, Apostle.
Yes, Lord, I receive that.
Not only that, but fear not.
Fear not.
And do not tremble.
My God.
Yes.
Neither be ye terrified because of them.
Yes. Yes.
And last but not least, verse 4, it says, for the Lord your God is he that goeth with you.
Come on.
Now, he ain't sitting back and he allowing you to do all the fighting. He's going to be there right along with you.
Yes.
Teach tonight, Apostle.
And not only that, Apostle Taylor, but he's going to fight
for
you, yeah, against your enemies.
Yeah. Come on, y'all hear that thing?
And now I'm telling you, y'all know that everybody's saying that we supposed to be coming into warfare to fight for God, right?
Yes, Lord.
So why is God fighting for us,
uh-oh,
against our enemies?
Uh-oh. Come on, girl.
I'm glad y'all asked. He's doing it because he's here to save you.
You better Jesus,
my Redeemer.
Yes, he is.
My God.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
See, we don't understand that if we just stand on faith,
come on.
We are already victorious.
Oh,
why? Because we have behind us.
Yes.
The person that created everything you see.
Come on, Apostle.
He said, put no one before me.
Yes, Lord.
Because I am a jealous God.
Hallelujah.
We cannot exalt no one else.
Yes.
See, we got a lot of them out here. Like I said, we got that. He has that crowd. He has those people that is way more than God's people.
My God.
But see, God said, with me, I don't need a lot.
I don't need it. My God. Come on here. Come on here.
Because I can win it all by myself.
Thank you, Lord.
My God, I thank you, Lord.
He said, I don't need you to do the fighting for me.
My God.
I just need you to show up. I need you to be that distraction. So I can go in and drop the bomb. Now, if y'all go with me to 1 Corinthians, I'm just going to go through these. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13. It says, there has no temptation taken you but what is common to man. In other words, what he's saying is the things that men will do, the thing that man will do on this earth will tempt you to go against what God put you here for.
My God.
See, the devil, he was one of God's favorites.
Come on, come on.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
So he gave him, as y'all all know, if y'all read your books, y'all know, if y'all read the Bible, y'all understand that he gave Satan,
oh my God, Lucifer,
the power that he had.
Yeah, yeah.
Told him to take it and do my will.
Yes, yes.
But being that he had his own agenda. He felt he was bigger than God. He said, why should I stand by his side and do his work when I got just as much power.
Apostle.
I mean, he gave it to me.
Yes, Lord.
So why do I have to follow him? Instead, I'm going to tell you people of God, or you so-called people
come
of
on,
God,
Apostle.
That I can give you the same thing he can.
Oh, my God.
He gave me that power.
Oh, my God.
But because he was disobedient to the word of God,
my God,
he had to be taken out of heaven and dropped.
My God.
So now he's come down here to possess this earth.
Yes, Lord.
And he got his followers because it says that he took how many?
One third
of the angels God already had. And turned them against God so he could have the glory.
You better preach, Apostle.
But I'm here to tell you.
Oh my God, come on now.
That you cannot beat the one that made you.
Right. You just can't do it.
You can't win it. So that's why he said, you can't be tempted more than what the common man has already done. But he said, but God is faithful. And you still read, we still in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. It says, but God is faithful.
Yes.
Who will not allow you to suffer.
Yes.
Or to be tempted above what you are able.
Oh, my God.
But instead, what he did is that he used the temptation of this earth, of this people, to make a way to escape the temptations.
Hallelujah.
Why? So you'll be able to bear it and still be able to give him the glory and testify on how good God is.
Yes.
Now, after that, he said that you're going to come into battle with these people.
Come on, we sure have.
That are trying to turn God's people away from him.
Oh, my God.
My God, my God, my God.
But see, when we went in, he said, my priests, that's
my God.
Servants who are diligently serving me.
Yes.
They're going to go in and they're going to speak to those people. They're going to speak to his people that are getting ready to go into battle for him and tell them, hey, look, don't let them scare you.
My God.
You better preach.
Because you're about to go in on this day to fight against them. This is what this warfare, this is what this revival is all about, ain't it? It's about the spiritual warfare.
Yes.
And winning the battle.
It's already won.
Yes,
it is.
Yeah.
And I'm going to get to the point on why it's already
won.
Because I know everybody's trying to figure out, well, if we're going into battle, how is it already won? So I'm going to explain it to you. He said, you're going to go into battle against your enemies, but do not let your heart faint. In other words, don't let your heart be taken just because it's 20 times more them than it is you.
Yes.
Right, come on, get in.
My God. Not only that, but he said, don't even fear them.
Oh, my God.
Because you have me behind you.
Oh, my God.
That me is being God, yes, Jesus Christ himself. He said, don't even tremble.
Oh, my.
Don't do it.
Don't be terrified because of how many it is.
Right. Can't bag down. Not at all.
1 Peter 3 and 18 said when he sent Christ down here to fix what the devil had messed up.
Woo!
He said, son, you're going to have to suffer.
Oh.
better
for the sins of my people.
Yes. That's good, Apostle. That's good.
He said you're going to have to do it for the just and for the unjust, that he may bring God into us. So he said, Jesus, this is your assignment.
Come on.
Just like he has assignments for all of us. Jesus had to come down and show God's glory, and what he's saying is going to come true. It's going to manifest as he promised. So Jesus had to go through this suffering and had to go through this sin, had to do it for the just and the unjust so he can show us God.
Come on.
He was even put to death. This is why I say y'all was in my sermon, because y'all talked about how he went to the cross for our sin. But check it out now. He was put to death, but he was quickened by the Spirit. Yes.
You better preach.
Yeah, I hear y'all. Ooh. I hear y'all on social media and Facebook too. Y'all saying, what is quickened? All
right. Oh.
What do you mean he was quickened by the Spirit?
Come on.
But let me tell you, quickened
yes.
in the Bible means that he was resurrected.
Oh.
That was good.
He was brought back to life. He was made alive again. Even after he gave the ghost.
Oh,
oh my God.
Come on, sir.
Oh, you better preach today, sir.
He told us that I will be back.
Sir.
Give me 3 days, y'all. I'll be back.
He told him.
He said, this has to be done. What you say, Apostle Taurus? It had to be done. It was necessary that he did this. And this is why we can win the battle.
Oh! My God.
Because he had to give himself up that we shall live sin free. Now, I know everybody's waiting on how this is going on. But this is how it's done. If we confess our sin.
That's the Bible.
He is faithful enough and just to forgive us our sins. And when he does that, this is what happened yesterday. This is the purification. See, he will cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We can't win a fight against unrighteousness until we get cleansed from unrighteousness.
Oh.
I mean, there's no other way around it. We can't tell you what's right if we doing what's wrong.
Now
that's right.
Amen.
That's
fine. Amen.
That's good, Apostle. That's good.
So now, y'all, how do we do this?
Wow.
We have to read the book.
Uh-huh.
We have to read this Bible.
That's it.
We have to study and do his word. We have to line up with what he's saying.
That's right.
So now, if you want to become that spiritual fighter, warfare fighter in this fight and claim the victory, we have to not lack the wisdom and the understanding.
Oh, my God.
So James 1 and 5, if y'all go there and y'all read that, if y'all read your Bibles, y'all know what it says. It says, if any of you lack wisdom,
let him ask.
Let him ask of God.
My God. Yes, he will.
I'm trying to show y'all how simple it is for us to win this war.
Oh, my God.
He said, all you got to do is ask me.
Preach, sir.
And because you did,
we ask for everything.
It shall be given unto you.
Yes, for everything.
I'm going to give you the wisdom, the understanding, and the instructions so you can go out and fight my fight.
Woo!
But now there's something else to that, and I'm going to get to it a little later. There's something else to that. It's going to be given unto you. All right? It's going to be given unto you.
Hallelujah.
All right. So that's why we don't have to faint. That's why we don't have to fear. That's why we don't have to tremble. That's why we don't even have to be terrified by the ugly destruction that is going on this earth on this day.
Oh, God, I thank you.
Why? Because God is with you.
My God, I receive
your Lord, Jesus Christ.
Thank you for being with me.
He's going to go with you.
Hallelujah.
So now that we know that God will be with us if all we do is confess our sins, accept him and acknowledge his son, Jesus Christ, as our Lord and Savior. Study and show ourselves approved.
Study.
Hey.
So now in John 16 and 33, now that he didn't gave us the instructions on what to do, it says, these things that I have spoken unto you that is in me,
right,
ye might have peace.
Yes.
Wow.
We can't have peace if we fight. So he's letting you know that if you just, now that I done told you,
you better preach.
Now that I done told you what to do, because it's in me, and if I'm in you, that means it's in you too now.
Hallelujah.
So with that, you can have peace.
You can have it.
The world is in tribulation right now.
Yeah.
It says, but if you be of good cheer, you'll know that I have won this.
Oh my God.
I have overcome it.
Oh my God.
I have died for it.
Woke up.
And then I woke up.
My God.
My Father brought me back to life.
Woo!
In other words, my Father quickened me by his spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, this body is just a vessel for his spirit to shine.
That's all. Illumination.
That's why he tells you, when you go out and speak my word, let your light shine.
Yes.
That light is him.
Oh my God.
So if you let him shine, the people will know that you are of God, that you are a victorious person.
Oh, yes, Lord.
God, I receive that. Woo! My God!
So now that we've gotten the information, and now that we have got the understanding and the wisdom of what we're supposed to do and how we're supposed to conduct ourselves.
Wow.
See, we can go to Ephesians 6 and 13. It says, wherefore take on to you the whole armor of God.
Yes.
That means he's giving you the breastplate. He's giving you the pants, the shoes. He's giving you the helmet. He's giving you the shield to block all the fiery darts that the devil is going to shoot at you.
Yes.
They show shoot hard too.
And you'll be able to withstand it. You'll be able to slay them down. He's giving you the sword that you can cut these devils down and take this evilness out of this world. It says, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God that ye may be able to withstand in evil days.
Yes.
Well, it's evil days right now. This is the evil days right now. But see, if we stand on Christ, we stand on his promise, we put our feet on solid ground, on that firm foundation.
Yes, Lord.
My God.
We'll be able to withstand, just like with me, Nicole. Just like with Hurricane Nicole. See, if we're not planted and rooted in the right fertile ground, see, Nina would have blew us over.
Oh,
because we are in God, we can watch how Nina went up under us. He went up under us, and then when he came up to do his damage, he went right around us.
What did I post before we got
home? He went right on around us. We right here in Jacksonville, Florida. Everybody said Jacksonville, Florida was going to go down right with Nick and with Nicole. They said that it was going to happen.
They said.
That's
your heritage.
Yeah. But whose report are you going to stand on?
You better preach.
Because God said, I've got the last say of what's going to go on in my world. He said, when I created this, I said what's going to happen and what's going to happen.
Yes.
So that's why it went right on around us. Just like you said, Apostle Nina and Apostle Taurus, how they thought and they prayed that we would not have this revival. I mean, it came from all directions, north, south, east, and west. I mean, I'm just going to give it to you. Everybody was saying, y'all shouldn't do this.
So did.
That hurricane's coming in. It's right outside your door. But God said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. He said, let no hurt, harm, or danger come upon your dwelling. Y'all see us tonight, don't y'all?
We're alive.
Don't they let you know God is God? God's promise and God's word will not come back void.
We're alive.
He said it wasn't going to happen. It didn't happen.
Because the devil ain't running nothing.
Devil ain't running nothing here. His time is up. His time is up. I don't like talking about people, but y'all remember what happened to Hussein. They said they were going to get him. They said they were going to take him out. Did they not take him?
They got him.
Why? Because they stood on God's word. God gave them the instructions and everything they needed to carry it out.
That's right. That's
so why wouldn't you serve a God like that?
He
said all you gotta do is follow my instructions. Yeah. He didn't ask you for nothing else.
Nothing.
He just said follow my instructions.
Follow my instructions. That's all.
Woo.
Apostle, that's a word. That's
and
a
you
word.
Will have life more abundant.
That was it.
Hey. So in closing, I want to tell you.
Boy, that was a word.
Woo!
Shut up, old man. Hey!
We're
going to go back to that John 6:16-33. He said, these things that I have spoken unto you, that is in me, ye might have peace.
Yes, Lord.
In this world, you have tribulations.
Yes.
But be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world.
Wow.
So in closing, if you stand on the word of God, that's all you got to do. If you just stand on the word of God, he will fight for you against your enemies that he may save your life.
Hallelujah!
Please save me, Lord. Yes, God.
Save us! All of us!
So he can bring you yes, up into Jesus. Heaven in the mansion that he Woo, has Jesus. Prepared for us. And we won't have to want for anything. So remember, as my wife comes up, Apostle Dr. Therial Taylor,
yes,
remember, only what you do for Christ will last, and you will be able to claim the victory.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Awesome word, Apostle.
Awesome word, Apostle.
Yeah, God. Thank you, man.
Uradaramande, the little boat, Shandy. Recotalabo, Yandaramasa.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Taylor Nation now in effect. Oh, my God.
Hey,
give me some strings. Give me some strings. God says it's time to seal this thing up. Come on, all the soothsayers, all the naysayers. Come on, y'all. I need some help right now. God says seal it up right now. Come on, y'all. I got the picture. Do y'all have a picture right now? We have won the victory in this spiritual warfare battle. My God. Give me some strings, son, on this keyboard right here. Come on, I want y'all to stay right there, right there, right there, right there. Do the running. Oh, my God, in the name of Jesus. Listen, come on. I want to let you know that God is in a mission right now. Somebody shout to the only wise God. The one that covers the heavens. Come on now. The earth. The whole what? Universe. My God, in the name of Jesus. Want us to shout out to our Chief Apostle B, Apostle Dr. Curly, and walk down the King of Connections, River of Life family. Want to just address this whole apostolic warfare spiritual team. Come on now. Apostle Covenant, Deirdre Ingram.
Yes.
Seer Prophet, Prophet Chu.
Hallelujah.
Y'all can come on, y'all can do better than that.
Hallelujah.
All the way from Nashville, Tennessee, Prophet Anna. Come on, put your hands together. My new baby in the faith of my shout. We are family. In the name of Jesus. And somebody shout, Nashville, Tennessee.
Yeah.
Our spiritual children. The apostles. Come on now. Come on. Toris and Nino Rawls and to Prophet Noel and Prophet Hannah in the name of Jesus.
I got a motion.
And I got to save my baby for last right now. Apostle John Taylor. Oh my God. If this man ain't came, but. To God be the glory. Taylor Nation, God bless you. And to our seed, all the way from Hinesville, Georgia. Minister music on these keyboards. Come on now, come on. This our personal musician. I came all the way to Afghanistan, to Nicaragua, you hear me? Venezuela, come on. I'll take them all over the world. Minister music. David Jackson, oh shall we won.
Yes,
we won the victory of this spiritual warfare battle. Hey. Come on, somebody shout. The harvest is plentiful. The laborers are few. Y'all ain't ready to go home. Watch this. Deuteronomy 20. Verses 1-4.
Oh,
it speaks about the laws about military service. You're wondering why we're wearing batis, camouflage. Come on, outfits and batis. Come on now. And
See, a prophet brought something to my attention. God bless your daughter. She said, you know what, apostles? It's strange that we are sitting in a land in Hinesville, Georgia, where the army is the army base there. Yes. And guess what? We sitting right there and we representing the army fatigue in the battlefield for the Lord.
Yes.
If the army people can fight.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
They can fight their enemy.
My God.
How come we can't fight the adversary? Y'all ain't saying nothing right now. We know the devil come to what? Kill, steal, and destroy. Come on now. Come on now. We've been dealing with this adversary long enough. Somebody shout, there's one opponent. And that one opponent is saved. Yeah, I'm not shaking. I'm ready to go home, but I came to God giving this word for y'all. Verse 1 says that when thou goest out to battle against thy what? Enemies. And sees what? Horses, come on, Prophet Anna. And chariots and people more than thou, be not what? Afraid. You can't be scared of him. Isn't that what the word is saying? For the Lord thy God is what? With thee. Come on now. If you don't know what thee is, come on. T-H-E-E. That means you. That means me. That means them. That means they. Oh, y'all left in my head. Which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. Huh? And it shall be when ye are come nigh unto the battle that the priest shall approach and speak unto the people. Come on, shall the priest shall speak. Come on. Yes. Not merely a recitation of what? Ritual. Priests sometimes accompany the army when it's went into the battle. That's what happened in the biblical days.
Yes.
The priests.
Yes, sir.
He accompanied.
Yeah. Come on.
Priests.
The people for battle. Huh?
That's right.
That means getting them ready, have a word to encourage them to go out and fight.
Yeah.
What happened to the body of Christ that we don't want to fight no more? We done got lazy. We done got what? Slothful. We done got sluggard. We don't want to labor no more.
That's right. My Lord.
So what happened in battle, huh? We seeing different ones dying. Battle ways that come on, help me, apostle. They dying while they in the battle. Ain't nobody covering nobody.
You better talk. I'll hear me, apostle.
We done stopped covering.
Uh-huh, my God.
We didn't even stop watching.
My God.
Everybody gets doing their thing. It's your thing, don't God. I do what you wanna do. It's not what you wanna do. You wanna do what you wanna do.
Come on.
But see, this battle,
yes,
it's not yours. The man's shadow is not yours.
It's not yours.
It belongs to the Lord. Y'all feel me? Uh-huh. Oh, my God, my God. Verse 3 said, then shall say unto them, hear, O Israel, you approach this day unto what? Battle against your enemies. Let not your heart what? Fight.
Yeah.
Fear not. And do not what? Tremble. Neither be ye what? Turned by because of them. That's what happened to the saints. They became the ants.
Woo!
That's good.
My God.
That's good.
They done got too scared, huh? They want to sit back and watch. Let y'all go on up there. Let somebody else do. No, God called you.
Yes, sir.
You say you the bishop. Come on, I'm walking up. I'm a believer. Yes, I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier in the army. You ain't doing nothing.
Not a thing. Hallelujah.
But singing a song. But your evidence ain't nothing. What is your work at? When are you going to get service that, Lord, I want to be sold out for you. Lord, I want to work while it's there, because there's going to come a time when no man will be able to work. I got my sword and my shield of faith. I got my heaven. Oh, Lord, my shaka of salvation. Come on now. What happened to that? We said it. We talking mouth, but saying nothing. Nothing.
Come on, apostle.
Nothing.
Watch this, watch this.
Come on, preacher.
It's what the text coming from. Four says that, for the Lord your God is he that goeth with you. Yeah. So that means when they leave you hanging. Leave your ministry hanging. Leave them from the wayside. Saying they with you while the going gets tougher. But then when they all talk about you, you get on this side. Baby, you can't straddle the fence in this hour. If you're a bona fide warrior, I don't know who to believe. I don't know which side I'm going to get on. Because I might get killed dealing with you.
My God. My Lord.
Come on. He says that God is he that goeth with you to fight for you against your enemies, to save you. So that's what we got to stand on, warriors. Stand on the promises of Jesus Christ. Uh-huh. If God is for you, who can be against us? Huh? Come on now. Yeah, we are apostolic. See, I know they get mad at me on Facebook because I really don't care, honey. But I'm going to tell you something right now. We are the apostolic. We are the remnant ones. We are the ones that's coming boldly before the throne of grace. We ain't got time for your junk. We're here to serve the people because God commands us to win what? Souls. To the body of Christ.
Yes,
we're winning more money. Then we win in souls. I'm going to step on this right here. I've been the one for the revivals. Come on, Apostle. For years and years. Doc, you bring me 1,300. Doc, I'm going to take you for 2,000 when I come to your church. Doc, how much you got over there? But everybody's still leaving at the door.
Same way, Apostle. Come on.
The same way.
Come on,
the same. No healing.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
No deliverance.
Yes.
Has taken place. But I decree and declare these last 3 days. The glory cloud showed up at 130. Come on, I do burn the road. The glory cloud showed up even in the midst of a storm. God said a storm can cease.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We watched the storm cease. I know God ain't crazy. God spoke in my ear. You feel me? Y'all what I'm talking about? He said, you go on with this revival. I don't care what, whose reports you're going to believe. You going to believe mine or you going to believe man? You going to believe me or you going to believe Satan? Whose report are you going to believe? You know what I'm talking about? Because I'm sold out. My mind is made up.
All right, Apostle.
Come on, Apostle.
I'm sold out. Social media, are you sold out for real? I can't tell you. He said, don't be afraid. Y'all scared.
Woo.
Some of y'all didn't show up because you were scared. Some of y'all didn't show up because you thought we was going to fail. But see, if the Lord is on our side.
Come on.
You better preach.
You better preach now.
That right there, Apostle.
Hey.
Because he's with us. Do y'all feel me?
Yeah.
See, when you don't come out, when you don't support, I love you, but I guess that storm is going on. Guess what?
Yes, sir.
The storm is passing over.
Yes.
The storm is passing over.
Yes.
The storm is passing over.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. It's the highest praise. Come on, I need y'all put your hands together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. The highest praise. Why? You know, saints of God, don't you know there's a time to win? There's a time to lose. Ecclesiastes teaches us that.
Yes.
But we are to focus on the Lord and you will triumph in the effort. Somebody shall make the effort.
Make the effort.
See, Roses and Minister David, y'all made the effort to travel.
Yes, God.
Yes.
Amen.
Come on now, we ain't listening.
When you made the effort to travel, listen, beloved, do you know that in a race, all the runners run, come on, but only one gets the prize?
That's it. My God.
Y'all don't hear me on today. In such a way as to get the prize. The main priority and perspective in this spiritual warfare battle is to what? Win souls. Y'all don't hear me. To go by the old Christ. Okay, the question is asked, why is soul winning is so important?
Yes. Come on.
Y'all want to know why?
Yes.
Come on, Taylor, I'm glad you asked me.
All right, now. All right.
Because winning souls in the body of Christ, it gets God's hobby. It gets his hobby. Because he know it's your heart is being pure. Because you care enough to see that a soul be saved. They don't go to hell. You're going to show them your life. I've been through some things. Come on. Your testimony that you live. Come on now. Come this. God said, oh, that's my hobby right there. That's my hobby right there. Because that's what I ask for you all to do is win souls to the body of Christ.
Right.
And when I heard heartbeat, I said, Lord, oh my God, it took me way back in the day. Heartbeat. You make me feel so neat. Oh my God. Because when you get God's heartbeat, you got his attention. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Yeah.
When you got God's heartbeat, you got his spirit. Come on.
That's it.
When you
That's
got his heartbeat, you walk in authority when God has called you to walk in. Oh my God, this thing is messing me up right now. Why? What is soul winning? Soul winning is preaching.
Yes.
The word of God.
Yes.
Giving someone, Minister David, an opportunity to give their lives to Christ.
Yes.
Amen. Yes.
And save them from going to hell.
Yes.
There is a heaven. That is a hell. You feel me, daughter? Come on, come on. In order to be victorious and a winner in this spiritual warfare battle, we cannot be weak-minded.
Come on.
That's right.
Not at all.
We got too many wimps.
Come on, you better talk about it.
In the body of Christ.
You better preach.
Falling to folks. Because you see what's going on with them. It's going to happen to me. And you still ain't got nowhere.
Spiritual
punks. Apostle, you better preach today. I like that. Spiritual punks in the body of Christ.
That's a good one.
I'm going to do right there. I'm going to do their format. Baby, the format they got, it might not be for you.
That's right.
But you're trying to, I'm trying to be like them. You can't be like T.D. Jakes. You can't be like none of these folks. You got to be like who God called you to be.
Come on.
You try to get God's heartbeat. So that's not the heartbeat of God.
I want God's heartbeat.
Yeah. That's why we are victorious. Come on, man.
Yes,
come on, come on. We can't be weak minded. Let me show you something. Apostle John Taylor taught me this about 8 years ago. We've been together for 20 some years. He told me about 8 years ago. He said, Therial, stop thinking negative.
Come on.
We must think positive.
Positive.
Amen.
Yes.
When you think positive, it equals to what? Positive results.
Yeah.
Somebody missed that. Come on, come on. Y'all missed that right there. Uh-huh. Y'all missed that. Come on, we got it. Because you know what a positive make you? Because you are more than a conqueror.
Yeah, uh-oh.
Because you are more than a conqueror. There's nothing positive. I'm coming out of bondage. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. Let me show you something. This is a win-win situation.
Come on.
When you make this effort to come out that comfort zone, because some of us too comfortable.
Uh-huh.
We too comfortable wearing all these chemises and caustic and these cross dangling around and got your shoes all turned up like an elf. You thinking you somebody big in the body of Christ. But let me say, if you notice right now, you ain't nothing but a wimp. You weak-minded. You following everybody, but not following God.
Not the elf, the
Come on, we need to stop being sick or tired. Somebody shout, I'm coming out of bondage. Come on. We falling asleep in church. You're going to die and go to hell. Falling asleep. You're going to get shot in this battlefield because you're sleeping. Come on. You're sleeping on the word of God. You ain't doing what God has called you to do.
Amen.
Come on.
Y'all listen to these false prophets.
Oh, talk about it.
Teachers. Preachers. Instead of what you were prospering. You still stuck in a rut. Somebody shut up. I want to come out this thing. I want to be like them. I want to make a difference. Come on. The anointing will make a difference in your life.
Yes.
I'm talking about to a bona fide warrior. I'm talking about somebody that's warfare in the body of Christ.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I got to get out of here today. Somebody shout, we have won the battle.
We have won. Yes.
Somebody shout, I'm victorious.
I'm victorious.
I'm victorious. Come on, y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm a winner. Come on, to my shoulder. I am on the battlefield for my Lord. Hey, I am on the battlefield.
Oh,
must be victorious. We have won the victory.
Yes,
Lord. I get it. Yes, I got it. I want it.
Yes, Lord.
I want it.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, this journey.
Yes, Lord.
Come to the front. We don't even say souls no more.
There's
a revival. There is a revival. Yeah. Souls are in state. In the name.
In the name of Jesus.
Of Jesus. Say to God, this coming out of bondage, healing, and deliverance. God, I thank you. Spiritual warfare revival.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout, we are winners.
We are winners.
Come on, put your hands together. We all won this battle.
Hallelujah.
I guarantee you, Jacksonville, Florida will not ever be the same. Well, I thank God Wednesday night, Apostle Deirdre Ingram, Pastor Nicole Pleasure, and then we thank God on Thursday night, the prophet all the way from Mobile, Alabama, Prophet Isaac Grove. Yeah. Come on, put your hands together. That's our new son. Yeah. That boy came up here and made some damage. He said, we are survivors. We survived. I thank God his plane had landed back in Mobile, Alabama. He can send us a text. We thank God for him coming through and doing his assignment that God has called him to do. Then somebody shout, Friday night, we thank God for this tag team. Somebody shout, Apostle Toris and Nina Ross, the preaching machine. Tag y'all in. Thank God for Prophet Anna. Her obedience coming in warfare.
Yeah.
Thank God for coming to you from warfare. We thank God. Come on, Taylor Nation. I know you got something to say. You want to thank everybody. And I want y'all to stand to y'all feet and guess thank the maestro, the minister, yeah, music that came all the way from Hinesville. Every Wednesday, every Thursday, every Friday.
Yeah.
See, this is warfare. When people don't mind working on a battlefield, and I ain't asking you how much you're going to give me, what you going to do for me. He just said, I'm coming. I don't care what's going on in my agenda, I'm coming. See, guess what? The best is yet to come in your life.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Son, shall obedience is better than sacrifice. You sacrifice your faith. So God go give it right back to
yes,
you.
Lord.
Give it back. Give it back to him, Lord.
Amen.
Come on, come on, Pastor John Taylor. Thank the people of God in this midst. Hallelujah.
Amen.